For everyone that's wondering why we're just yelling and laughing on this side, TK has joined us on this episode of Noah Hall, the podcast. Welcome, TK.
Thank you for having me back, you know.
TK is a legendary veteran guest. He's been on quite a few episodes in the past and has been very goatish. This is episode 33 of Noah Hall, the podcast.
Yes, yeah.
This is your boy, Tunde.
Your boy.
Joined by my amazing co-host.
Yes.
Super Lord Bawo.
Gift them.
You are not here when Super Lord became.
They were given out Super Lord. You weren't here.
It's okay.
It was the same. You overslept. You missed your Super Lord blessing.
That's valid. I can see how you were left out of the Super Lord combos.
Yeah, so it was. They had three.
Wow.
I collect one.
Jesus.
I will come back later. You know, we'll come back. So okay. I'm the only Super Lord in town.
No, don't worry. I'll go to Nigeria, but Ari will give me my own Super Lord.
So TK, how have you been, and where have you been?
I've been where you guys left me, in my father's house. I've been in my father's house, you know. Usually, I'm always working, but to God be the glory. That's me day off today. So I am here to spend it with my two favorite agbayas.
I think like last time you came, you didn't have your permanent tooth.
Ah, this teeth has been working fine.
Because it's one thing, so I call it tooth. It's one installation. It's multiple teeth, but it's one piece.
It doesn't fall out anymore.
It's a tooth.
It doesn't fall out.
Because no. They're separate, but they're not separate.
I had them painted yellow, so no one would know the difference.
No, you told me.
How you got a set of tooth.
you know. Pass me all them tooth.
It's painted yellow, so unless I show them the original picture, they will say, wow.
No, but I get it. I appreciate you keeping the struggle. Like, I'm not going to have white tooth in front.
White
and white, yellow teeth everywhere else.
Mash
the struggle.
No, you have to.
And
mash
that's
it.
What we should talk about. That. See, like you're like one of them. You're like a chick that got a fake butt, but your shit matches your thighs.
You have to, you know.
No, his shit. Well,
I claim it.
You gotta let
him
know your hands. No,
I claim it.
Now
he. My
hands fucking the other way, but not.
Whoa.
I claim it.
That sounds like an unbelievable threat that I don't want to be a part of. But anyway, no, because, you know, chicks will get a fake butt.
I've seen
it. And it doesn't match the thigh.
And the leg.
You got your fake tooth set.
And it matches.
And it matches the teeth. Huh. And you painted it yellow.
It's not because that, but knowing the people I have around me, you guys won't talk.
Oh, no,
this.
I will roast you till
you guys will say you have mayonnaise and butter on
your
teeth.
I need you guys to know, if you're my friend and you die before me, even in your funeral. You're going to catch a light roast. You're going to catch, like, yeah. I'm going to look at you. I'm look at
your
you
family's going to be like,
what? If it's open casket, I'm like, oh, dear. Rest in peace, Sha, my guy. I love you forever.
The family's going to be like, who lets him talk?
Yo, God forgive me, because it's happened a funeral before. Like, but it wasn't the guy we're making fun of the babes that were crying. We're like, ah, you entered that one. God forgive me. I've come a long way. I've come a long way. I'm a way better. Like, you know, I grew. My conscience grew with me. I wasn't born with a big conscience. Like, my conscience is now, you know.
Bruh, you're different.
I grew into my conscience.
You pulled up to a funeral.
I didn't pull up. We walked there. I didn't have a car yet.
I did not.
Because you know, some people are just over crying.
Yeah. I'm Nigerian, bro.
No. Okay, so home. Rest in peace to my guy. I don't want to say name. I don't want to put stories there. But a friend passed, and then they were just like this two babes. Never seen them before, blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? Family don't really know who they are. They don't know who they are. And then she was just bawling. You don't know who this person is. No.
Really?
No, this was years ago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, before I said, that's what, before I had a car, I walked. Wow. This was like, this got to be a decade, almost a decade. Yeah, almost a decade ago. So, now she was bawling like out of control. Man's was like,
it happens, man.
No, it happens. You know, some people are more emotional than others. But at that age, you know, you're just thinking.
God forbid, Barton. I know from my own people will say, a bastard is finally gone.
You think so? No, there will be a few people, but not plenty. Not plenty. All those babes you're lying to. Because, man, you lie to a lot of people's daughter.
And
that's one big, especially. She'll be babe. Like,
She's gonna fly first class. Let me tell you about that TK.
I should come and think about it. How would you want to be dressed in your coffin, bro? Let's talk about it.
Shirtless.
I don't. I really like. We're all gonna die. That doesn't.
No clothes. Let them see my breasts.
So you would like to be
nude?
Or you could dress. You know how Ghanaian men dress with the one. No. You could have one tit out.
Just show me everything.
Both breasts.
Both breasts out, man. Well, I came into this world with nothing. I don't want nothing. Tunde is really taking off his clothes. Once we mention breasts,
Tunde has like, just shown us his.
Tunde has been telling everybody he's been working out, man. This thing just fall over.
He can't wait to
you
show.
You get past Kardashians.
Fams, we have one person that whose tooth matches his teeth, and you are doing summer body. Good. Yeah, the thoughts are here. 25th
summer body, indeed.
You people just wait until May.
Give them a date.
I give them May 1st.
May 1st is when it will happen.
Just throwing cars.
It's
around.
Gonna be May.
I'm just going to lift cars off the ground. I'm like, hello.
Wow.
What's
so
good?
You've been hitting the gym. Give them. TK is rubbing his hands and calling them papi just now.
TK.
This is going to be a horrible episode.
You need to relax.
Yeah, if you're listening, stop and go back. Turn around.
Restart the whole thing.
Yo, let's start all over. Sure, nah, but so you don't have an outfit in mind in which you're gonna wear for your funeral?
I do not even. I don't think I've ever considered any of that.
This I need you guys to know. Like, I'm going to code it to my Yoruba people or more Yibo. Just well, I think my Niger people and African people know what Oyibo is. A Oyibo person just walk past as we were recording. Because I want our non-Yoruba
person. In translation, in God's name, but she didn't stop.
No, bro. This is not for only Yoruba people.
Most of them are Yoruba.
As a non-Yoruba person. Yes, so I'm going to explain it. I'm going to explain it in English and you're going to do it in Yoruba.
No problem.
Okay. I walked inside the house. Ori ninu ile. He took off his pants. Obe trouser. Sile.
So basically, we're in an undisclosed location, right? And it's a shared space. You're not translating.
Awani, location tech, Bodomo. But I didn't share location, yeah.
Man said share location. It's a shared space.
Shared area, lawa.
If you continue, I want Lagwajan Debe.
Okay.
Wow, there you go.
Okay.
So anyway, we're in the shared space, and then. Oyibo individual.
Oh, that one call about.
Fams. We're gonna touch on this topic later. I'm out of it. Anyway, so TK, but real shit. What would your outfit for? What, like right now, if somebody's listening, God forbid, we all know we gotta die at some point.
Yeah.
You can't enter heaven or hell if you don't collect death stamp.
Okay, this is true.
So don't mind. Today
I don't know why you just leave it. You should just leave it at heaven.
No. Some people know they're going to hell. Some people know that, you know.
Not our portion.
Amen.
I can't suffer in earth.
I wish you guys heaven.
I can't suffer in earth. I will suffer in hell. Okay. I'll cry.
Anyway, Tunde is the one coughing in the background. He's lost it a long time ago. I hope you guys get a person that speaks or understands you're about to explain something things. You gotta do a lot of editing this episode.
Oh, yeah, I promise you all this is being left in. Pause.
What? 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 Wow, leave it in. So, but what outfit would you like to wear? Shouldn't they think about it?
Because me now,
No, please, English.
English, I just want nothing. Give me not just
for like
nothing.
You want to be naked in your casket?
Yes.
Has that ever happened?
I feel like it's not gonna happen. I'm sure somebody has asked, like, yo, make sure I'm naked in my casket, but they're not gonna.
I don't think that's ever been.
I think some aren't there. Isn't there things where people are like, yo, put me upside down, like backwards, so they could kiss my behind, like they could see shit like that. I've seen that, but I'm saying I've seen that request been made.
Come,
like,
if so, they can stand somebody up in the corner. They can leave me naked in my casket.
Yeah, because I've seen people like get dressed and put on it. Like, so you really want to be naked in your casket?
In my casket, you know.
How would you want to go?
Sunday's best, Nani.
So you want a nice three-piece suit?
That's it. You?
I'm willing to, like, yo, for the highest bidder. You know what I mean? What? If Nike want to pay to have me in a sweatsuit, I'm down. Like, give it to my family. Whoever is willing to pay, you know how it is? Like, Fashion Nova could send some bread to have me in an overfit. A little man.
So, right. What if somebody wastes, let's say, let them put you in, like, latex costume, like...
Fams, if they're going to give some money to the fam, I'm down. Yo, they can... Yo, please... A nice Fashion Nova fit, and then they put it on the gram. Look about what going off in this Fashion Nova man fit. I'm down with that. Oh my God. I'm down. You think, if Fashion Nova is still going to be popping when I'm gone? There's going to be something. Fashionverse. Shout out. Like, I don't know who paid to make Fashion Nova so popping. I'm not sure. Okay, so we're going to carry on. Okay. We're going to carry on from this. But no, for real, for real. All the people that love me listening. So anyway, all the people who love me, when I go, I need you guys to hit up all the trending sites, fashion sites, and see who's willing to, like, you know.
That they will be so confused because everybody's going to try to figure out what happened to Bawu, but they'll be asking Bawu.
Yo, imagine me in some nice off-white fit. Off-white, you know, with the little tags they be putting on the shoe.
They'll be like, Bawu.
You don't think that Ghanaian man would be down for that?
So, Bawu, if Gucci say they want to donate money, you will collect it. Yeah.
Listen, I mean, my casket come and beats me. I'm wearing Gucci. Come on. Oh, man. Nah, for real, though.
Let's go back to the story.
For real. But, yeah, back to the story. So, okay. We out here chopping it up, talking about your man's taking the shirt off because he's been working out.
I want to be my bus shirt. I'm sorry about this. On your bus sita.
Your man's tuned there, by the way.
Yeah.
So as we're doing that, in this shared space, Oyibo man walks in. You guys should know what Oyibo is. If you don't know, it's going to be in the description of the podcast.
Bashi, I'm better and so Oyibo can call over. What the fuck is he?
Man's was in here. He's part of the offshirts gang.
I want Boshi Wally, all that baby, I'm a sweatshirt, sweatpants, the work, or shirt, because Sinko Combell.
And
sweatshirt, sweatpants, the work.
And we're also going to have what offshirt gang means in the description. Right here for you. We're going to be teaching them pigeon small. Yeah. No Wahala. No Wahala, by the way, is what Timon and Pumbaa would sing if they ate pounded yam a little more food. It means no worries. We'll talk about that off air. Disney needs to cut us a check because I hear they're trying to own the phrase, right? Yeah. But anyway, so back to our situation. Yeah. So Mans came through, Team Offshirt Gang, no draws, just walking around this space.
Side note, Moshe, why open me a web bathroom, bro? Hey, get share web bathroom.
I don't. Okay.
You might pay attention.
So we're gonna move on. Again, that's the end of the story. That is the end of Solomon Grundy. But we're moving on. Are you guys okay with that?
Yes.
So you said you'd be naked in your casket.
Of course. No.
You said Sunday's best, and I'm saying IG sponsored post.
I said Sunday's best, but
what is your Sunday?
I said Sunday's best, but more Sunday.
Three piece suit. I said
no.
Okay.
More and it.
You want that better?
More and it on just Sunday.
So Sunday will make your clothes.
Sunday, not my sponsor. I shall team up.
See, we are talking sponsor. You feeling the sponsor?
We're
way?
There. We're there.
Oh, now everybody. Yeah, but now.
Because
I want to collect money. You know.
Kid money pelu Fashion Nova.
DJ any money?
No. Wow. And I go the diet. And I wash here.
There's a whole lot of Yoruba going on here that I have nothing to do with. I have nothing. So back to the topic at hand. I wanted to bring this up. I don't know if you guys saw the new. Are you okay? What did you collect? Okay. So a UFC champ, Ninja guy.
Ninja know the carry last.
Yes. And then we had another Nigerian brother in UFC win another belt. I don't know if you guys remember the guy that was like...
Never-experienced
guy. He's breaking records, breaking U.S. records in Texas. He's a school out there. Anthony Joshua has multiple belts. We have Giannis Antetokounmpo, also known as, what's his Yoruba name? No, what's the Antetokounmpo chain?
Adetokounmpo.
So there's that. There is a bunch, there's just a bunch of things happening. I feel like African kids are breaking bound. Like even Embiid, Adebayo too.
I never expected his name is Divine.
Divine, yes, that's his name. Divine Oduduru.
Wow.
Yeah, I remember. I remember he was he second or third place against Usain.
No,
he's not Yoruba. He's not Yoruba. I think it's one of the smaller tribes.
Yoruba don't name their children Divine.
Yeah, Divine is definitely like. No, he's not Yoruba.
What language is that?
I'm not sure. I think it would be one of those by river.
Divine, if you're listening, help us chime in.
And he's intervention. So someone should invite him to South by Southwest.
I never expected it, sure.
But anyway,
Delta.
He's Delta.
Yes.
See?
That's your cousin.
No, we're here now. We're breaking records.
Okay.
I feel like Delta names always aren't Yoruba, but look Yoruba.
You want
like
to start trouble with a whole bunch of people
Jesus
that like...
Jesus is Lord!
Wow, never mind.
Never mind. Yeah, this whole part will be taken out.
Yeah, just
just delete all that shit.
If you are listening, run back. Trace your steps. You know when you lose something, your first step.
I'll just punch you again.
Your fam's been working out too. He's just punching me. But no, back like it's something crazy now because there seems to be a good amount of people stepping out the continent and just getting the opportunity. Getting the facilities, getting the training, getting 24/7 lights, getting meals on the table, and then just doing a lot with it.
I mean, you know what it is? I feel like as Nigerians, we already understand. I mean, our parents saw it before we did, but you kind of have to leave Nigeria to win in Nigeria.
You have to
leave Nigeria to win as a Nigerian. And it's very interesting because there's people that I've met here, there's people I've met in the UK that are of Nigerian descent. Their parents born and raised in Lagos, born and raised in, Abeokuta, or born and raised in Kaduna or Jos or whatever. And they come here. Oh, let me not forget my Calabar people because, the ethics always claim that we leave them out, but we know the Vuato. And their parents came here, started basically planning their futures. And they're all doing well now. They're nurses or they're entrepreneurs or they're lawyers or they're in finance, whatever it is. And they're basically being compared against their Nigerian counterparts on the continent. And
they want nothing
to do with Nigerians.
But the crazy thing is, it's not, we all know we're not playing from an even playing field. Mm-hmm. So you can't, the opportunities are different. It's just what it is. If Anthony Joshua was boxing in Nigeria, I don't think he would be where he is now.
Absolutely not.
It's just what it is. He was actually denied boxing in Nigeria. They told him he couldn't do it.
They told him he couldn't?
Yeah.
Really?
He said he tried to represent Nigeria in the Olympics or something like that and do whatever.
He probably refused to pay them.
Whatever it is, obviously are there people.
Allegedly.
No, there's a whole thing about, he spoke on it a minute ago. So it's just, people don't get that opportunity. People aren't given just a chance to be themselves and do whatever it is they want to do or chase that talent. Because even in the community itself, they want you as doctors or lawyers, and then everything else is just seen as a fallback plan. And then you have somebody now, Anthony Joshua, sponsored by Beats, I think. I forgot what sportswear. I don't know if it's Puma or Adidas or something like that. So he's getting the sponsor money and he's doing commercials and all that. Oh, I think he's with the one Steph Curry's with. Under Armour, I think it's Under Armour. So it's we have all this things we can do, but we're not really given a chance. So it just makes me wonder, when are we going to get there where kids get equal opportunities with kids all over the world? Because that was one thing that even bothered me when I was in Jamaica, just watching young black kids. And I'm like, bruh.
You were Kendon?
No. I'm just thinking like
Daryl. Oh, gosh. You were drinking rum with
go for it. One more.
Let me see.
You have one more.
Jarrell.
No, Jarrell.
J J E.
I was gonna
said that's a different continent.
Wow. Sorry.
I'm chilling. But no, no, no. It's
sorry.
It's just
Delroy.
Delroy. There you go. You were to Delroy. Nah, but it's just crazy to me because it's like, I can't think of an amount of black, I don't know how many black countries we can say, yo, if this kid grew up in this black country, they will have a good chance of being good or just being it or being the best in the world. What black country do you think there is out there that you're like, yo, if you were having kids and you're like, yo, you got to raise your kid in this country, what black country would you choose?
Right now?
Yeah.
Rwanda.
Rwanda? And why that? Because I've seen some things, but yeah, I don't.
They are, when it comes to like advancements and tech and.
How about education, security, all that?
I mean, from what I know, they're mm-hmm. leading all that stuff right now. They are a model country right now.
So Rwanda, you would say is number one country black-wise that you would.
In sub-Saharan Africa, yes.
Well, there's South America.
I thought you meant.
No, let's black. Any black country, yeah. Caribbean countries.
Caribbean can be dangerous unless you have a lot of bread.
So you feel like if there's a good amount of bread in the Caribbean, you can
at least
your kid stands as good a chance as anywhere else.
Well, your kid can stay alive enough to experience the goodness of wherever they are, for sure.
Gotcha. So Rwanda
and South Africa for me.
Rwanda, South Africa, and maybe a country in the Caribbean if you're like balling out of control.
Maybe the somewhere in the West Indies. Brazil?
If you're super rich?
Super rich. Rio, why not?
Because I've heard there's a Brazilian saying that says the richer you are, the wider you are.
That's anywhere in the world.
No, it's like of popular.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised. South America is very racist.
Very much so.
Any place that has been colonized is pretty.
Any place.
Any place.
Any place. That has is pretty racist.
Yes.
Oh, you're black?
Oh, yeah. You guys were conquered.
You came a little late. We would have showed you a little more love.
The Portuguese kind of told us that you guys aren't worth monkeys. So, nice. Yeah. And the British came and basically made it even worse, but it's fine.
Because I think the more black athletes or whatever it is, breakthrough in avenues they weren't like particularly great in, the greater the chance we have kids doing new shit, you know? Like, I'm sure the black kids are inspired by Tiger Woods. I'm sure the black kids are inspired that, you know, they're going to be. Tiger Woods? Oh, yeah. You know, that man was not trying to be anything. Yeah, I'm everywhere. He's all lives matter. And that's why he leaves voicemails with his fuck. I don't even want. He upsets me. Whenever I think about Tiger Woods, I get upset.
I'm going to need you to pick up your phone and I call you. All right.
Hey, this is Tiger.
Hey. This is Tiger.
Friends, I need y'all to know this. This is going to sound very, very male. Like, just like a black male. But if I'm a billionaire or I'm touching billionaire and I'm cheating on my wife with you, I'm not leaving no damn voicemail. I need you guys to know black men don't cheat. Please. Black men never cheat, dude. Can't cheat.
I do.
Well, you're not a black man.
I'm Nigerian.
Yeah, Nigerian men that aren't black. You were born in Nigeria. That don't make you black. Let's talk about that later. But no, black men really don't cheat. Who have you cheated on? Say her name right now. Hashtag say her name.
My hands.
This is your idea to bring TK here today. You take responsibility of your guests.
TK vanishes for a few months. Now y'all understand. When is
no, but black men don't cheat. So that's one thing. And Tiger always let it be known he's not a black man.
Yeah, it's never happened. I've never seen any example of.
But for real,
even the recent effort, Tristan Thompson, people are like, yeah, what about Tristan? You can't cheat on someone you're not with. Tristan's been basically single for 3 years.
No, she's been in a relationship with a single man.
She's been in relationships with many single men.
Hey.
Wow. Just because you choke and have a baby with somebody does not mean that you're in a relationship with that person.
Single men.
She knew what it was before she even.
No, she likes single men.
She wanted to be what do they call it?
They try to. Oh wow! But we don't talk about that family in this podcast. I don't know.
I don't even know what family you're talking about. I just know that there's a gentleman that couldn't cheat because he wasn't in a relationship to begin with.
Say less.
That's it.
No, I get
black
you.
Men don't cheat.
But yes, the Tiger. Whenever I hear Tiger, I get upset because there's no. If I'm a billionaire, first off, I'm buying you a phone.
Which Tiger is making you upset? Should be Tiger, lots of young money. I be golfer.
There's Tiger the rapper.
There's Tiger from the Basement, or Tigger, or whatever.
Wow.
And then there's Tiger Woods, y'all.
Just a lot of people that want to be
Tigers.
Tigers. I don't understand.
Just
what is wild?
Antelope. Wow.
Antelope.
Atlanta loop.
Awatan loop. No. Atawatan loop.
You are loping.
Atawatan loop.
You are loping. At your big age, you are loping.
Anirogun loop.
Go and find wife. Stop loping.
Loop. Loco Jesu.
Stop the loping.
Mo ye. Am I loop? Matia loop. Rara. Sorry, we basically
took, don't say we.
Okay, well,
because I'm not speaking about Bible for now.
Our group took the word antelope, and it eventually spun into it spun into a bunch of entendres that were lost on the untrained
quadruple entendre. Don't even ask me how.
Correct. There were puns that were very specific to the Yoruba ear. So I apologize to our non-Yoruba speaking people. This
just means that you need a Yoruba person in your life. Wow. I'm looking for a new friend, though. Oh.
Man's making the podcast a hookup session. He loves
turning our podcast episodes into like live Tinder dates.
Sam's swipe.
Hey, babe.
You're giving up Tinder for lunch?
You see?
Because that was the next topic. What are you guys giving up for lunch?
I give up Tinder when only fat girls hit me up.
Wow. We're body shaming.
Of course.
We're body shaming. So what are you giving up for lunch?
Your future now?
Yeah, body shaming is crazy. Lunch?
I've always body shamed. Wow. Your
that's
future.
Proudly future.
That's crazy.
I don't know what I'm giving up for lunch.
You pull up to the club and tell the big girls they can't come in?
I tell no. I just tell point to my brother. How do them?
Wow. Shout out to Kenny.
He's in a relationship.
Wow, why are you trying to get your
talk? In the past, Kenny doesn't party anymore. He hasn't partied
anymore. Respect your brother.
For like 4 years.
How you not respect your brother?
I respect him. Kenny. Please edit, I respect that, him, please edit that picture for me. You know,
I respect him. Insert name here.
But,
we came out at the same time. Whatever. Yeah,
for Lent, I think I'm giving up. Mm.
You're giving up? Mm?
Come to me, Lash.
Hey, yo.
Maybe when you guys
please,
talk.
Please give him the mic back. Pause.
Man said, come to me, Lash. What does that mean?
Guy can't decide if he wants to be an eloper or an R&B singer.
See? Look at who you are loping with.
Just loping every
said, time. Come to me, Lash.
Loping every which way.
So tonight, what are you giving up for lunch, bro?
I am giving up responding to stupid questions.
So after lunch, you will continue.
I mean, I be feeling bad sometimes, but I feel like for Lent, I'm just gonna, like, if I read it and it's stupid, I'm just not gonna respond.
Okay.
Yeah.
I feel like nobody has given anything substantial.
Okay.
So there has to be something hard.
Substantial. Like, whoa, like, whoa, you know, whoa.
Something hard for you to give up. Can I finish my sentence?
Oh, finish.
Yes. So it has to be it has to be actually not just yes, you're growing through it, but it can't just be fun.
I've decided to give up candy for Lent.
There we go.
I will not eat candy the entire Lent period.
Is that the babe's name?
Wow.
Oh, sorry. Oh, candy. Okay. I thought it was a babe's name. You said you wanted to eat candy.
How dare you to be loud like that.
Stop being so
damn loud, my guy.
Hey, is a family show.
You ever put something in the group chat and you instantly regret putting something in the group chat?
And you can't undo. This is not WhatsApp. You can't
just delete the message for everyone.
Shout out to WhatsApp for creating that option.
You can only talk to Bao on WhatsApp moving forward. Because I put some stuff in the group chat sometimes, and Bao would just be violating. He'd be like,
just
remember
that
time, that thing that I knew not to say on the, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to just say it.
It's cool. It's wild. I'm that guy. I'm the basket that can't hold water.
No, it's okay.
Carry on. You figured it out? Yes. What?
I'm going to give up going to getting DB like every week.
You're going to give up Senegalese food?
For a week. For a week.
How long did you just fast for a week?
I'll give it up because I'm in there like every week, like twice a week.
Man said, every week. So before 7th of DB, you're giving up.
Maybe my waist will reduce more.
No, fams. No, we're not.
You guys are saying that body shame.
No, you should. No, we're not saying it's good or bad. We're just saying you're not losing any weight.
Especially by the time I come back to this podcast, it's my body loading.
So it's loading. Don't mean it's loaded.
It's gonna be here. I'll just come back in 10 years.
Okay. Take your time and come back, bro. Let me see. I wanna give up meat.
Whoa.
Yo,
I saw that.
Yo, Bawo. But it's are you okay? No.
Like I think I'm gonna just do red meat.
Yo, Bawo.
Wow.
Bawo.
Wow.
No, no, we have to travel. You'll be cooking all the food for us. Don't give it up yet.
Bawo. Never gonna give
it. Are you going through something right now, bro?
I'm going through growth, bruv.
What? This whole combo is wild.
Yo, I know. This is a very wild conversation. Yo,
this is crazy.
It's very crazy. Okay. I'm going to move on.
And all this is just convenient because we just watched the Michael Jackson Neverland documentary. Now you're talking about
I
now
did not.
Growth.
As you're a black about man.
Random growth and meat, bro.
Whoa. This is how you transition into Michael
Jackson.
The man whispered in your ear and said you are not alone. And this is how you do it.
I didn't watch that documentary.
Because you want to be man in the mirror. I bet keep yourself over there, guy.
So I'm gonna
don't tell me about human nature. No, please. You are dangerous.
Wow.
And it's bad.
Wow. This is a thriller for you.
Well done, well done, well done. Well done, well done.
Okay.
Well done.
No, but
is somebody watching me? Guy.
No, for real. How did you feel about the documentary? Yeah, that could be your response.
That is my response.
Because it's like, it's a weird thing because Mike has been an untouchable for...
That's another one.
No, I know why we went there. But you know, for a while with the community, like black community, African community, whatever it is, Mike is just that guy where it's like those who feel he did it or he's done it or it might be true are outliers in the community. Mm. Like the black, not like just in general, like the black community. So now, there's still people that feel like it's a propaganda because obviously people felt he was killed and assassinated and by his doctor. It's just a weird thing. But I love that it's coming up during the R. Kelly conversation because now we have somebody else who's been accused of something. Obviously, there's a video for R. Kelly, you know. But he's alive, you know, and we get to watch this madness happen. I don't know if you've seen the interview.
No, for real.
But it's just a weird thing to just deal with it. Because Mike, we all grew up trying to moonwalk. We all grew up all that. And then we also grew up listening to I Believe I Can Fly, you know. So it's so weird. They're two different people to us. Like, maybe because we watched Mike grow up.
Yeah.
Like, we have Afro Mike. We have, you know, Triller Mike. Yep. We have Hair Down Mike, you know, all that. We have Mike, Jericho Mike. We have Mike with a mask over his face, dipping his child. You know, there's so much. It's just like a transition in which we felt he was being transparent because we got to see growth. But just because you get to see somebody grow doesn't mean, you know what they're doing. So I feel like it's weird. It's just like I don't know what exactly people can show us for us to be. Like I'm talking community-wise. For us to be like, you know what? There's some sex shit going on here or like something ain't right.
I agree with you. I mean, I grew up on Michael's music. Michael alongside Quincy have probably been two of the most influential Americans in my life.
Okay.
Musically. You know, we all grew up hearing allegations and stuff. But when you're dealing with someone that... had a bunch of cases against him. The FBI basically looked into your case for a decade. He beat it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? No matter what Liberian girl
you ask. Oh, gosh. Yo, you have no shame.
You know?
No shame.
You know?
And mind you, there's no Google needed in this, by the way.
I'm just saying, do you remember the time?
I saw that coming.
No, I'm just asking you.
I remember.
Do you remember the time where you would... Whoa, TK.
This is not the case, sorry.
No, just remember
him touching PYT.
First of all, wow. You're disgusting. First of all, I don't remember that time, Mo. I don't know that time. All I know is that, TK, when they come for you, I'll be there.
I'll be
I
there.
Just what need y'all to know, like, this was supposed to be a serious topic.
No, but we're trying to be serious. No, we are. Over here making us scream.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, dog.
This is in my idea. It wasn't like your...
You're trying to be black or white.
Oh, wow. Guy. Wow. That was actually good. Chop knuckle.
So this is, yeah.
It's another part of me. Don't worry.
Okay. Okay. I think I'm to blame because I started with you and not alone, but this is...
Whoa, wow. Well,
so yeah, there is no longer any respect for Mike Jackson. I'm guessing, you know, I really hope you guys pull these people in the street and let them know a little bit, like, man, how you feel about this. So no, but real shit though.
Look, let's shout out the fans because
we have to. This is after important topic.
After last week, have to say we've been looking at the comments and the messages and just like the likes and the shares and, you know, the love never felt so good.
Yo,
you know, I'm just saying, you know.
All right, man.
I was just saying.
But
are y'all done?
Yeah. But to piggyback off what Bob was saying, this is somebody that we grew up. I remember in Nigeria when the lights came back on, and I saw tree.
Yo, what? I sound wild. As a child in Nigeria, we're talking about Mike Jack. When the lights came back on, it's very
suspect.
Problematic.
Okay, wait,
Nepa
come.
Even Nepa itself, the name Nepa comes from the way Michael Jackson.
Hey.
You know what I'm saying? Nepa. That's what they.
So, guys, again, I have a lot of respect for Mike Jack. Status reports from your favorite Yoruba reporter.
We need to have like TKB the Yoruba reporter.
Like, and reporting now.
Right.
Yo, how would you do it as a reporter? Like, yo, TK as a reporter would be hilarious, just breaking in.
Did you see the hood report?
Yeah, he got hired by BET.
Yeah, I mean,
now, come on. Let's not limit ourselves.
I would love to have him on like an actual.
BBC has BBC Pigeon. So you should find out about the BBC Yoruba because there's.
One already from.
All right, there's one more.
Reach out to me and say they're looking for casters. You know, TK will be one of the first people I reach out to.
Guys,
TK will miss the
interview. Uh-huh.
TK that will miss his own funeral by 10 minutes.
Ah, more than 10 minutes in Jesus' name.
TK, I do. My arm on your eye with this dog.
Don't worry. Casket driver will take time here.
What?
I cannot come and die. Just go.
So. Nah, but real shit, that's it. I'm trying, guys. I'm trying really hard to stay on topic. Two of your bad boys are disturbing the whole frequency of things. But why do you feel like, okay, so what do you think is the love level with these artists in the black community? Because I feel like in them defending this stuff, because I feel like R. Kelly is beloved.
R. Kelly is beloved, but Michael is idolized.
Right. That's what I'm saying. No. So it's just crazy that I feel like the R. Kelly thing happened. I don't know if it happened quick because obviously it's been years. They've both been years, right? Like it's just, but now,
well,
it's just being
the
shattered.
The documentaries now. Nah. Timbaso, you hear me? I like a lot. But now, who produced?
Again, that phrase too will also be broken down in the bio. Everything you're about, you guys have to write in English so people can know.
Be able to breathe.
But now, this is my thing. The reason I feel like the R. Kelly one was, what network produced the R. Kelly skin?
Isn't it Live? I mean, Lifetime.
Who produced the Michael Jackson?
HBO.
So it's two different. I believe like with the R. Kelly one, the way they did it, they kind of appealed to more women. Oh, this is a monster we have to go after.
Right.
This is what he's
well,
done.
He's alive as well. Yeah. There's not much, you know what I mean? Like, he's alive. So it's like, this man has to be taken off the streets.
And especially, they were upset that he was still making, getting on
the
show.
Getting money, yeah. And then the Mike situation is like, yo, did you know what I mean? Did you know about this? Like, or like, what you were thinking might be true. So it's just weird. Like, because I've just been watching the reaction of people with Mike and with R. Kelly and seeing how it is.
And then also just being thankful for our non-problematic stars.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like it'd be, because even when, remember when Whitney, like when Whitney passed and it just started coming up with all the shit she's, like her issues with drugs, and then Pusha bought the album picture and all that shit. So it's just, well, Kanye bought it for Pusha, whatever.
Well, now, quick question now. Mm-hmm. So go on this one. Now, let's say, if Bill Cosby has passed.
Cosby as well, yeah.
If Bill Cosby has passed before
all the scandal. Buying NBC.
But before all the scandal came out, mm-hmm. how would the world take it? Would it have been the same outcry?
I think it would have been way less of an impact, because he wouldn't be there to defend himself, and that accusation would have been brand new. Because then with Mike and R. Kelly, the accusation was going on. Well, R. Kelly's alive. But with Mike, the accusation was going on when he was alive. You know what I mean? So it's like, it's something he knew he was being accused of. But now the Cosby thing didn't really come out to the public until then. So if he had passed already, I feel like the community would have been like, nah, y'all bugging.
Yeah.
You know, like I think it'd be like, nah, he's not here to defend himself. You guys just want to tarnish his name and his legend, da 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 da. But
makes sense.
So that's where I'm at. But I just wanted to see, talk to you guys about the Kelly and the Mike thing, because that comparison is it's such a weird feeling how people are like reacting to each of them.
Yeah.
So do you have your music? We're going to cover one more topic. You get to select the music this time. Do you have a music in mind?
I know. I mentioned that and you guys just said no. Naha.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Hey. Money, baby. X-Y-G, Syria, Nigeria, representing Africa. Hey. For all my Yoruba people, if you don't know that song, you're a dead guy.
Thanks for remembering that. But yeah. So, anything else? You want to cover? I feel like we spoke about South by Southwest and the artist. I feel like everybody's excited. Those who are going, I've spoken to, are very excited for what's to come. They added my guy, Bills.
Yes.
To the lineup. Shout out to Bills.
That guy's a dope performer. You should check him out if you're going there.
Bills is definitely going to be here for a long time. Who else? Were there any other changes? So please, if you're from Austin or been to Austin and there are African spots out there, please let us know. Because we're looking at things and it's not looking too promising.
And if you are volunteering to cook.
Oh God, please no.
Bao says no, but me.
Whose house are they entering?
I'll enter your house. There just you let go. Mom see know that I'm your cousin from London.
From where?
From London.
You with a British accent would be hilarious.
I don't have British accent. I'll carry the British accent with me.
Okay, cool. So, yes. Song of the week. Do you have your song ready? I have mine.
And go down.
You want me to start off the wave?
I'm going
with Dave. Because he just dropped his album today. I'm sorry to hear. And the story wasn't genuine. The song name is called Black. It's from his new album, which is dropping today, called Psychodrama. If he's black, he's probably armed. You see him and shoot. Look, black is growing up around the barbershop. Mommy saying stay away from trouble. You're in yard a lot. Studying for ages, appreciating the chance you got. Cause black is in your blood and you ain't even got the heart to stop. Black is stepping in for your mother because your father's gone. They're standing by your children when you haven't proven karma wrong. Black is doing all of the above, then going corner shopping, trying to help a lady cross the road to have her walking off. Black is growing up around your family and making it, then being forced to leave the place you love because there's hate in it. People say you fake the shit, never stayed to change the shit, but black is being jealous, you'd be dead if you had stayed in it. Black is struggling to find your history or trace the shit. You don't know the truth about your race because they're erasing it. Black has got a sour fucking flavor, here's a taste of it, but black is all I know. There ain't a thing that I would change in it. Look, black ain't just a single fucking color, man. It shades to it. Her hair straight and thick, but mine's got waves
black
in it.
Black has a dark visual to it.
If you guys get a chance, please, please, please listen to it. And that is my song.
Can I just put two songs there? Just two songs.
You are a guest. Well, been, I guess since you are our guest.
It's been a minute, you know. One song, you know, Simi, you know, she just released a new track called Aya. I absolutely love this track, you know. I feel like Simi's voice speaks to me.
If you're the dogs, you don't mind them. You got a belly, call me, you buy them. My time don't call me, yo. I owe a bad baby, yo. Here, yo. I owe me, day, oh. I owe me, day. Every day, oh. Showers of blessing rain on me. She not money where you want, oh. I be your fair amount, oh. Time, you don't come, oh. I owe a bad baby, yo.
That song really speaks to me. If you haven't checked it out, definitely check it out. And you know, and another song that I love when people incorporate Obey vibes. I love Obey and Chief Deji Bami. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah, baby, yo. Come on, be my lady, yo. Oh yeah, baby, yo. Come on, be my honey, yo. I know go leave you, la la. I'm all you fall like flower. I know go leave you, la la. I'm all you sweet like flower. Oh yeah, buy me love. 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 Oh yeah, baby, yo. Come on, be my baby, yo. Oh yeah, baby, yo. Come on, be my honey, yo. Daddy, what's in my heart? I will give you my love. It's in that I'm feeling. I can give you my soul. I need your love. A tender care and touch you, baby. Thank God for blessing. I'm all for you, no like you, not all. I look into your eyes, girl. Your beauty make my heart swell, baby. We go on in me. Oluwa, no send me well, oh.
You definitely incorporate, oh, yeah, that. Now I would give it to the great one himself.
Shout out to Simi and Chief Deji. You know, TK, Lord of the... Wow, that's weird. Very strange. This guy just kissing anything anyhow. Weird.
Whoa. I don't want to know.
it wasn't the Oshé Mario Winans.
I don't want to know.
Oshé Mario Winans. Ha, let's see. Let me see. Which record am I going to just... Hey. Actually, the record that I would love to premiere,
okay,
on this episode of Know How the podcast,
is actually
a very interesting one.
Talk to them.
Shout outs to my
premiere, it's King.
Shout outs to my guy Afro B.
Oh,
we're going to drop the Drogba Joanna remix.
She what?
Okay.
Boom.
Joanna. Joanna, drop by beware of Joanna.
Joanna.
Make me bring a million in the briefcase.
Joanna,
spending one night like a Mayweather day.
Joanna,
Joanna. She make a ninja turn demon.
Joanna,
she got me drinking from the Garden of Eden.
She gon' seduce you, got you laid in the shack. Many men made it in, not one came back. Joanna, I love you. Last words from his mouth and then he jumped out the plane with no parachute.
Hey, Joanna, Joanna, how you do me like that?
Hey, Joanna, Joanna,
how you gonna do me like that?
Joanna, Joanna,
hey, Joanna,
hey, Joanna, Joanna,
ay, ay, ay.
Hey, how you gonna play me like Drogba? How you gonna do me like Drogba, ho, Drogba, ho? Oh, DJ Drogba, ho, Drogba, ho. Eh,
Shaku anyhow.
Don't worry. My Shaku is very wayward.
Just so wayward Shaku. Wow. And shout out to Ultimate Clientele Conglomerate. Yeah, that's definitely going to be the record to lead us up into the festivals that are coming up in the spring and the summer for sure. Yeah. Boom.
That was a dope record. Didn't even see that coming.
Even the ones that are like 6 years old that TK picked.
Which one is 6 years old?
No, it's okay. It's fine. It's nice. It's okay. They're all nice. Not me. Shout outs to Mrs. Gold.
Okay.
Mrs. Kune Gold.
Not worried.
No. I like them.
More like
here. Wow.
I think Kune will beat you.
He will beat you. In fact, Kune will beat you mercilessly. Before you wake up. I know you. Before you wake up.
So I'll be there and you let somebody beat me. Bow.
If it's one on one fight, what should I do?
He'll beat you and I'll be singing. Ire, ire, ire.
Listen, all my friends.
Ire, ire, ayo.
All my friends. If you
want Lu, you.
Again, this has been a Yoruba podcast episode.
One kema bo, ire.
I have nothing to say about this.
Chop this beating from the other side.
After I chop the beating, I'll tell him you are my favorite artist.
That's what he said. When your teeth will fly.
Cemented,
your dentures cemented in your mouth. Oh, we didn't know.
Fams, the remix is still going on. You had to put this at the beginning.
If I had known, the teeth you are looking for was scattered on the road
on the way to Canada. This episode. We should this has to go in the beginning of the episode, and we got to let them know to listen to the episode in which TK was on before.
I never expected it.
Oh, sure. Mm.
Yes.
Nah, but before the intro, you got to move this to before the intro. So we have to tell them what episode to go listen to before they listen to this. So they appreciate, because some people might just listen to this and not appreciate TK's previous. Yeah, so check the. There's a lot of bio checking you should be doing for translations for all the random Yoruba-ness that happen.
I'm teaching a Yoruba class soon, you know. I fail Yoruba in Nigeria, but I can teach you Yoruba in America.
Fail Yoruba how?
F9. How? Don't worry. They told me I was coming to America and I
he can't spell. He told me I was going to America. He was doing Ghana, Ghana. What's up? What's up, man? What's up, my nigga? You know, anybody don't. Yes. Anyway, thank you, Hall. Thank you all for listening to the new West Wahala.
Thank you for having me.
Episode 33.
It's been a pleasure.
Not 33.
Shout out to everybody that paid attention this episode. Shout out to our guest TK for him and his toothless adventures. We have a lot of exciting things coming up too, but let's keep that in our pockets.
Yes, next episode shall be special.
Mm. Shout out to our sponsors, you know what I'm saying?
Shh.
Where they're at.
We can't. The sponsors, how does Khalid say it? The sponsors vocals, are they in yet?
Yeah, those sponsor vocals, are they?
Are they in yet? Yo. Shout out to Khalid. Khalid would really post some shit with no volume.
Absolutely.
And then be like this, and that's him promoting his new song.
That's it. We gotta get. Wow,
who wants to put my finger?
That's
the name of.
TK's been trying to fart.
That's the name of the podcast episode.
TK's been trying to fart. Yeah, I'm just giving him names.
In fact, the smell is confused.
The smell confused the letter. I gave him one letter before. Oh God.
You know what's crazy? Tunde farted in the last episode. So this is just.
Did I leave that in?
I've been suffering. I don't know. I don't remember. You might have left it in because you. Pause. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Goodbye, folks.
Yeah,
bye.
We out.